Let's talk briefly about the spectrometer or the spectroscope that you'll use in the quantum mechanics lab to determine the wavelengths emitted by atomic sources and an incandescent light bulb. The function of this device is to take an input light beam, which comes in through this sort of boxy-looking area in the upper right, and split it up into its component wavelengths, which end up falling on a wavelength scale in nanometers on the left. In fact, there's actually a diffraction grating near the bottom of the device that accomplishes this, and if you look at the diffraction equation, you'll understand why a diffraction grating is able to split up a light beam into its component wavelengths. To actually use the device, you'll want to look through the eye hole that's at the bottom here, and you'll want to look initially down the right-hand side. So you'll notice along the right-hand side, there's sort of a straight line that runs from the boxy area near the top down to the eye hole. This is where the input light comes in, and you'll want to look at this first so that you can line up the source with the boxy area at the top. This area contains a slit, and that's where the input light comes in. So, for example, if we line this up with the hydrogen lamp that's out ahead like so, now on the inside of the device, I'll see the wavelengths of which this beam is comprised in the top left. You can kind of sweep the spectrometer back and forth like so until you get it right on, and you can use your lab partner to help you stabilize it once you've gotten this in place. Once you've gotten it in place and you're seeing purple light come through the input slit, look to your left and you'll see the individual wavelengths as different colors with sort of the same general shape as the input beam on the wavelength scale. Look at where they are along the wavelength scale and record the wavelengths that you see. If you look on the top of the device, you'll notice that several common wavelengths are listed here. And one way to calibrate this device is to use the fluorescent lights that are in your laboratory. You'll notice that mercury is on this list, and it's got a line at 546, which is its characteristic green line. So you can simply point this device at the fluorescent lights above you to calibrate it. And to adjust the scale, you can move it along the outside like so.